It's Thursday, so it's time for our Monday staff meeting. My name is Wedgie Rudland, and I'm the new super-duper smart Harvard-educated president of entertainment at BET.
Yep.
Do you know why I was given this job?
Because you're super-duper smart.
Yes, but why?
Because you went to Harvard.
Yes.
Yep.
But why would they want a super-duper smart guy who went to Harvard to run BET?
I know.
Because it's time to take BET in a new direction.
Right on, Wendy.
Remember the first day I showed up, I asked, what's our highest rated program? And you guys said...
106 in Park with AJ and Free.
Yes.
Yep.
And I said, great, fire them. Why? Because what you call success, Wedgie Rudland calls failure. And vice versa. See, when people ask me, have I made BET a success, I say no. It's time to redefine success, because once you embrace failure, you can't go anywhere else but up. That's a business theory they taught me at Harvard. It's called negative elevation. Now, I know I may be going a little too fast for some of you,
yep.
But I'm happy to slow it down. Are there any questions?
Is it true that you put a ban on 2- and 3-syllable words, man?
Good question. Yes. Our research says we need to be focusing on the monosyllabic demographic. I believe lots of syllables confuses our viewers, especially those in the South.
I got a question.
Of course you do. You didn't go to Harvard.
Do you have any experience running a network?
Okay, see now? You're a hater. You're fired, so get on out of here.
I haven't been paid in 3 months. This is basically volunteer work for me.
Oh. Well, quiet down so the rest of us who are getting paid can work. Thank you.
You're the Harvard man.
Okay. I would like everyone to please look under their chairs. You will find a copy of the Black Panther comic book that I wrote. Please read it carefully. This is the kind of super cool stuff we'll be doing at BET from now on.
Chicken?
Yep.
Are you kidding me?
That's your complimentary lunch. And the orange is your new healthcare plan. Antioxidants. Very important. Wait. Nope, nope, nope. You don't get any. You were fired. Okay, let's talk about some new shows. As you know, we're starting BET Animation. Here's what I want to see. I'm thinking rappers, young MC roller skating, edginess. He's going too fast. His brakes don't work. We'll get Tone Loc to do the voice. Okay, How about an animated version of Hamburglar? He's a hungry thug. It's gritty like The Wire. He does a drive-by on Burger King. McDonald's can co-finance. We'll call it Beef. Wait a minute. I'm seeing a Flintstones thing happening here. Dino could be a Rottweiler. Maybe a pit bull. Instead of Bedrock, we're in Africa. We're keeping it real. You got that?
Got it, Wedgie.
All right. Next up, reality. The Ruckus reality show. I'm digging it. I'm feeling it. It's what's good. Let's do that show.
Wait a minute. Is this the show about the black man who hates black people?
I hear that tone. The head of Viacom personally asked me to make this show.
He was being sarcastic.
No! Excuse me? Which one of us went to Harvard, huh? Did you go to Harvard? You think you understand white humor more than me? You know what? Shush. You don't even work here anymore. Now, the rest of you, get a crew. Get out to Woodcrest or wherever that guy's from, and let's make the Uncle Ruckus show happen.
I am the stone that the builder refused. I am the visual, the inspiration that made ladies sing the blues. I'm the spark that makes your idea bright. The same spark that lights the dark so that you can know your left from your right. I am the ballad in your box, the bullet in the gun, the inner glow that lets you know to call your brother son. The story that just begun, the promise of what's to come. And I'ma remain a soldier till the war is won. Run, run.
I wake up at 4:45 in the a.m. every morning. That's about 12 hours before most niggas wake up. I am a very spiritual person. I start each day by thanking the white man for the sunrise, for the land I walk on, for the air I breathe. I also apologize for niggas, but Lord knows they ain't gonna apologize for themselves. I am not black, nor do I consider myself to be black. Many people mistake me for being Negro because they don't know that I am currently living with the heartbreak of revitiligo. That's a skin condition that's the opposite of what Michael Jackson's got. Every morning I apply this topical ointment made of bleach and sulfur. I like to think it works. Luckily, I hadn't gotten much darker in the last few years. As you can see here, I enjoy building small shrines to certain special white people who are important in my life. This one here is dedicated to John Wayne. Great white man. Didn't take no shit from niggas, Indians, nor Mexicans. And this one here is for George Bush the First. Loved him. Now this one here is dedicated to the most soulful soul singer to ever live. Yeah, I work about 32 jobs over the course of a week. I think it's interesting I got 32 jobs and most niggas say they can't find one. Niggas. Now, one of the great pleasures of my day is taking all these pretty little white children to school in the morning. Hey there, Mr. Billy.
Move out my way, fat boy.
I keep the bus nice and clean for them. These kids... Oh, excuse me. Oh, hello there, Miss Madison.
How is my little sunshine?
Whoa. Hold it right there.
Hey, man,
where's the gun, huh? Where's the jug? Go on, get out of here. Go do your little hyphy-fifey dances and nigger monkey shuffle somewhere else. This here bus is for kids with a future. That's right. Get your lazy ass to some exercise. Y'all should just go be rappers. Get into a beef and then shoot each other. Desegregation ruined the American school system. When did test scores across the country drop? After desegregation. When did drug use and violence in schools go up? After desegregation. There were never no white kids shooting up nothing before they started going to school with niggas. These little angels wouldn't even know what a gun was. The white man is a peace-loving man. People say the key to fixing the problems of Negroes is education. But I say education is not the answer. Why bother? And what do niggas do in college anyway? Oh, they go there. They party, get drunk for 4 or 5 years, and end up just as ignorant as when they came in. You ever seen these nigger fraternities and sororities? You ever seen these things? Silliest shit I ever seen in my life. You think Aristotle turned to Achilles and said, hey, let's create a fraternity and jump up and down barking like dogs? Hell no. White man out there getting Nobel Prizes and doing business deals in the fraternities. Niggas jumping up and down with candy canes and doing all kinds of silly shit with their hands. People say there's no difference between races. Well, I tell you what, I've been cleaning bathrooms for a long time, and I can say white man shit just don't smell the same as black African shit. See, the white man just got a better liver. White man eats his meat raw. See, that's healthier. He calls it tartar. How you doing this fine day, sir? May I say your dookie smells like sparkling ice water
Jesus. With
a twist of lime. See, that's why he don't have to wash his hands neither. Yes, sir, white man has impeccable hygiene. Hey, that little mulatto girl, you waiting on your daddy?
Yes.
Yeah, she talking about her daddy, Tom. He married to a white woman. Lucky some bitch.
There he is.
Sorry I'm late, Punkin.
Lord have mercy. Tom, is you wearing a skirt?
This isn't a skirt, Ruckus. It's a kilt. It's part of my Scottish heritage.
Now, you stop that right there. That's blasphemy against Mel Gibson and the proud Scottish people.
Mel Gibson isn't Scottish.
Hush your mouth. The Scottish man deserves better than you making a mockery of his history.
But, Ruckus, I am part Scottish. 32.5%, actually. I just found out. I took one of those tests where they trace your DNA and tell you your exact ethnic makeup. It's fun. You should try it.
You 30% Scottish? Black as you is?
I know!
Is this a white doctor or a doctor that gave me this test?
Not that it matters, but yes, he was white.
Well, hell, that's all you had to say. A white doctor is 99.9% reliable. Black doctor is an oxymoron, unless it's a witch doctor. Well. Who knows? Maybe I'll take me one of them tests.
I mean, why should Alex Haley be the only person to discover their roots, you know?
I'm sorry, Alex what?
You know, Alex Haley. Roots.
Roots? What is that, some kind of gardening show?
You're joking, right? Roots. You know, roots.
I don't follow you.
Roots! You've never heard of Roots? The miniseries? Come here, honey. Hold on. Here. Roots!
I don't.